Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back. I'm going to be checking out Family Feud Greatest Answers. If you are new to the channel, hit that like and subscribe. If you've been on the show before, thanks for coming back and checking out another one of our videos. So as always, we're just going to jump into it and check it out.
Bill only one strike. Talk to 100 women. Name something the Pillsbury Doughboy and your man have in common.
He's white.
He's white.
Oh, man, that's funny to me. Man, that's the best answer I've heard. I love real answers, man. Well, I can't think nothing else, Steve. I'm looking at him, I'm looking at me. Hell, both of us is white. I'm gonna go with he's white.
Come on,
Rocco, let's make it happen. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much fun is New Year's Eve?
It's an 8.
Name something people might get too much of.
Money.
Name something people name something people fill with water.
A bottle.
Try again.
Cup.
A pool.
Name the most popular cereal.
Frosted Flakes.
Name a job that's dirty, but someone has to do it.
A plumber.
Try again.
Of course. Dirty. Gynecologist.
Oh.
You married, Rocco?
Not yet. Couple months.
Yeah, I better check with her after this one. Yeah. Well, your buddy's at work when this goes on TV. That's the best ass I've ever heard. You stunned the world with that one right there. I don't know if we're going to have enough tape to show the whole thing, but pretty sure they do on YouTube.
That was funny.
Rocco, let's go, buddy. On a scale of 1 to 10, how much fun is New Year's Eve? You said it's an 8. Survey said. Number one answer was 5. 5. Yeah, a lot of people don't have a good time. Name something people might get too much of. You said money.
Wow.
Survey said.
Yep.
Food was the number one answer.
Yeah.
Name something people fill with water. You said swimming pool. Survey said. Number one answer was bottle. I said name the most popular cereal. You said Frosted Flakes. Boy, when I was a kid, me and Tony the Tiger had a thing going on. Survey said Cheerios was the number one answer. Got 128. We are 72 away. Name a job. Name a job that's dirty, but someone has to do it. You, my man, are going to be so famous after this. You said
that.
I can't even repeat it. Survey said.
No.
Number one. Point values have doubled. Here we go. Top 6 answers are on the board. Name something that follows the word pork. Pork lawn. I thought you said lawn like the grass outside. I was going, what the hell is a pork lawn? Lawn! Looking for the pork loin.
Pork lawn.
Joe?
Pork belly.
Pork belly.
Sean? That was a little excited. Yelling and stuff.
What am?
Name something that follows the word pork.
You pie.
Huh?
Pork, you pie.
You pie. Pork, you pie.
This is the greatest answer I've ever heard. No, I feel you. It's number one.
Oh, my mama.
Pow. It's number one. Oh, really? Well, I'll tell you what. It's going to be number one on YouTube, but... It ain't gonna be no water. I bet every dollar I got. You the only person that said cute pie. Cute pie!
Chop.
Rob, tell me something a farmer's wife might accuse him of caring more about than her.
His farm equipment.
The farm. More specific.
Is ho?
I kid you not. I couldn't have wrote a joke better. The best damn answer I've ever heard as the host of Family Feud. No,
I really appreciate it.
Damn brilliant.
Thank you.
Now,
thank you.
It ain't up there, but that is the best damn answer that ain't on the board I've ever heard. Cecily, good to see you. Your sister Tanya. She put up 23 points. Hands on your hip, three with her. That's the bad news. Here's the good news. You need 177 points. You need just about everything there is to get. But guess what? You can make it happen. I'm going to ask you the same five questions. You cannot duplicate the answers. If you do, you're going to hear this sound. You will not hear that sound this round right here. Don't even worry about that. Trust me, you won't hear that sound. We could have just slid right through that right there. Because if you hear that sound right now, I'm diving in the crowd. Okay. Are you ready? All right, let's remind everyone of Tanya's answers. Your 25 seconds on the clock, please. Your clock will start after I read the first question. We asked 100 men, name a part of your body that's bigger than it was when you were 16.
Your penis.
It's in time. It's in time to clock, bro. It's in time to clock.
Not so good. I I said the medical terminology.
I don't care what you said. Could have said ding-a-ling, winky, any damn thing. What the hell? It ain't gonna sound right. The medical term is almost worse. A slang term would at least be your ding-a-ling something. The penis! Oh. We're keeping that answer. Okay. Name a word that starts with para.
Paralegal.
Name a kind of knife.
A steak knife.
Name something you'd see on a football field during the games.
A goalie.
Name a food that often gets judged at a state fair.
Pie.
Name a word that starts with para. Name a kind of knife. Yeah, look at her answers. You think that's goalie. Shocking? Where do you see this first one? We asked 100 men to name a part of your body that's bigger than it was than when you were 16.
You think that's shocking?
You calmly said that.
Where do you see this first one?
Survey says.
Yes, one of the men to name a part of your body.
Number one answer was stomach.
All right. Stomach. That was close in the area.
You calmly say.
If your stomach is that big, you can't see it anyway. Survey says. Number one answer was stomach. Then I said, name a word that starts with para. You said paralegal. Survey said. The number one answer was paragraph. Then I said, name a kind of knife. You said, steak knife, survey said.
Then I said, name a word.
Number one answer was butter. Butter knife. I said, name something you see on a football field during a game. You said, the goal.
I meant the goal.
Then I said, name a kind of
knife. I know. After number one, it doesn't matter what you said. Looking for the goalie, survey says. Number one answer, football players. Then I said, name a food that often gets judged at the state fair. You said, pie. Pie was the number one answer. All we need, 156 people.
Then I said, name a food that often gets
yes, we can. Survey says.
You said,
83 points. $415. The same family. They're going to take another shot on Family Feud. I'm Steve Harvey, everybody. We'll see you next time.
Like, it's always funny. Certain hosts I don't think do well, but the hosts they've always had on Family Feud have always been pretty good. His reaction to a lot of this stuff is really amusing. So I always enjoy seeing Steve Harvey host this show. I had never seen this particular video before, you know, about different combination of answers, the crazy answers people give. It was pretty interesting, pretty funny. As always, I think I'm going to wrap this one up. So if you guys like this video, hit that like and hit the subscribe. Till next time.